Right. Very good morning, guys. And so, as per the continuation of the previous session, we are discussing about the fifth unit of microprocessors and microcontrollers. In this fifth unit, we are going to have the topics regarding CORTEX, ARM CORTEX processor, and OMAP processor and its architecture, which was the continuation of the ARM process. So here in this session, we have discussed in the previous class about like when it was started, the ARM CORTEX, which is all about like in 2000, we have started 2002. At that time, we have started this ARM CORTEX processor, and we have three different series in ARM CORTEX, right? So like ARM CORTEX A processor, ARM CORTEX R and ARM CORTEX M. So all these processors are regarding like A is for application oriented processors. A series processors are regarding the application oriented system like mobiles and tablets like that. And R is for real time oriented processors. They are meant for real time oriented. There you can see the automobiles, right? Best example, what I can say, like automobiles are the best example for R series processors. And even we have M series microcortex processors, right? So this M series is all about like embedded related projects we can design, right? So in this we have discussed all about like this ARM CORTEX processor, its architecture, and the individual modules regarding ARM A series CORTEX processor and ARM R and its architecture. And then here is the ARM CORTEX M series processor. It all started with M3, M4 CORTEX processors, and which was the version of ARM V6. Here itself, I have the thing is all about like a few points. When we are discussing the architecture of the few ARM CORTEX processors, in this ARM CORTEX process, internally in the processor, how many registers it consisting of, we have not discussed in deep, because already in previous unit we have discussed about like the ARM controller will have R0 to R6. The same will be having here also. So this ARM CORTEX process also going to consisting of total R0 to R15 registers, total 16 registers. Adding towards this, we'll be having CPSR, one CPSR, and depending upon modes, we'll be having six different modes of operations here. So all for six operations like FIQ, IRQ, we'll be having SPSR registers. Like that, the same specifications, whatever we have discussed in the ARM7 microcontroller, the same will be having in this CORTEX process even. And few CORTEX process will be having additionally few more specifications. What were the additional specifications that we are going to discuss here, right? So coming towards the ARM CORTEX M4 series processor, here it is also CPU ARM version 7 architecture. So here it is also a 32-bit, and the pipelining stages is also like 4-stage pipelining it has. Additional to this, we are going to have a nested interrupt controller. Nested interrupt controller, like a vector interrupt controller, where we'll be having the vector addresses. And wake up interrupt controller, so that to manage the interrupts. And memory protection unit, digital signal processor, DSP, and FPU, floating point unit, and data watch point and breakup point unit, ITM trace, ETM trace, JTAG, and serial wire. So here we'll be discussing about these points. So coming to the FPU, which is my floating point unit, where it is helping us to get the calculations regarding the floating point values, and digital signal processor is required when we are going to add some signal processing applications in our controller or in our design. And JTAG, which is abbreviated like Joint Test Action Group. This JTAG module is helping us to connect with the computer, right? And the other systems. So that is what for JTAG. And ITM and ETM, it's a debugging unit actually, right? It's a debugging channel for sending the message for code to debugger, right? So that is what ITM, and ETM is a chip hardware can stream out a step-by-step walks through the instruction stream. So these two are all about like helping to get the debugging and execute the instruction, right? So this is what the ITM and ETM is for. And coming to the controller, wake up controller. So guys who are new to this, just mute your mute yourself. Right, just get mute yourself and wake up interrupt controller, which is like a peripheral that can detect the interrupt and wake the processor. Means it's all about like when processor is going on with the some execution, or when the processor is in sleep mode, at that time if we get some interrupts, at that situation this wake up interrupt controller module is helping us to get the interrupt and wake the processor. And the same way, watch point module, what we have. So watch point module and break point module, we have two, data watch point and break point unit. These are helping us to break the point instead, like stopping the total instruction. It is allowing to stop the CPU on a memory access, right? So when it is all about like getting confused with the one particular instruction, so at that time we'll be trying to stop the access of the memory, because of like if we get confused with some particular instruction, we are trying to stop the memory access, and we'll be trying to give some instruction towards the commands, otherwise we'll be trying to restart the total application. So this particular breakpoint, data breakpoint or watch point, is helping us to check the instructions, is that the perfect instruction, and to go on with the further access of the memory, right? So this is about the ARM Cortex processor, guys. So this completes the types of ARM Cortex processor, right? So these ARM Cortex processors are helping us to maintain so guys, when you are joining, just mute your calls. Don't make me to do this such thing. When if you guys are not unmuting yourself, so I'm helping you to leave the class. So right, when comes to the ARM family, so this is what the ARM Cortex family, guys. So where you can see the classics here. So classic processors like ARM7 microcontroller and ARM9, ARM11, these are the classic processors. Only it has the ARM specification, right? So you can take that ARM7 and you can design. So coming to the embedded related applications or application related, so slowly that is what we have tried to start Cortex process, which have additional few more specifications, few more additional features in that, such that we can design the embedded related or real-time related or some application related process very easily. So that is helping us to go with the additional things. That is what embedded Cortex process, right? Which were like embedded M series and R series also, right? And additionally, we are going to have application Cortex process in this, like A series processor application related. So this is all about like ARM Cortex family, right? So this is the overall view. Fine. So coming to the next processor is OMAP processor. OMAP in the sense Open Multimedia Application Platform. Guys, coming to this particular OMAP processor, it is all about like Texas. So Texas Instrumentation Company or Texas company, they started this particular OMAP processor, right? So this OMAP process, particularly when you come across like some particular, if you design a process, we design in such a way that it should be helping to the all the environments, not only this particular environment. We plan to that this particular processor can be helpful for designing any other all types of embedded applications, right? So this Texas were started in such a way that when it comes to the mobile, so if you can think it all about, like even if I take the ARM Cortex A series processor, right, it has floating point unit, it's okay. But the thing is, like, I want to access the videos, I want to access something like some embedded applications. Even I'm using, like, the thing is, like, it should work with finger biometric authentications, and it should have some like IR sensor in this, so it should have some cameras, and if we can go with some capturing the images, and I should have some image processing, signal processing, all such things. Additionally, if I want to design a mobile in such a way that more and more applications are required, so to design a mobile, which was, I can say as an example, which was started with 3G, third generation mobile, which can having the multiple applications inside this, right, which are having the multiple applications inside this, so which cannot be happen within the only things like having the ARM Cortex A series, which are not only sufficient enough actually, right? So that makes us to go with the new type of processors like OMAP, right? It's a combination of STM and other Texas companies. So, right. So, yeah, this was started in 2002, December, with the coordination with STM, Microelectronics, and Texas jointly. They have announced this OMAP processor, and it is intended to use it in 3G mobiles, right? So in 2003, how many mobiles we can see such an OMAP process, or like in Nokia, like N19, N9, N90, N91. So such series of mobiles you can see OMAP process. Most in Nokia mobiles you can see. And of course in Samsung Galaxy Tab 27.0. So these are the few series of the mobiles which were used in Samsung. And in Sony Ericsson mobile, again Samsung and Nokia. So like that, a few of the mobile companies were using this sort of OMAP process, right? So this type of OMAP process, what are the architecture about the OMAP processor, and what makes the additional things to go with the OMAP processor? Let us see the architecture. So this is what the architecture of OMAP process, right? So in this OMAP processor, guys, I'm not saying it is fully different from ARM Cortex, it was included. Yeah, you can see here, this OMAP processor includes ARM Cortex A15, A series processor, one A15 Cortex, and also two, here you can see two cross dual ARM Cortex M4 M series processor also. Including this, you are going to have few more. That is what you have to see here. So video coprocessor, radio processor, display subsystem, video input, MMU, memory management unit, DMS, direct memory access, VPE, and USB port. You should have, you will be having two USB ports, dual USB ports, one is 3.0 and the other one is 2.0. Anyone can access it. Few systems you can connect with 3.0, which was somewhat early, new advanced version. We can make speed up. Otherwise, you can go with USB 2.0, and you have UART, which was like a protocol, universal asynchronous receiver and transmitter, SPI protocol, DSP protocol, H2SC, CAN, QSPI, and the RAM, shared RAM, SATA cable, which were trying to interface with the system, asynchronous NAND and NOR asynchronous, which all these are regarding the storage, data storage or program storage, related memory units, and connectivities. We have few more connectivities here. PCI Gen 2 and EMAC and MLB. Right? So these are the few connectivities. These are all the external peripherals you can see here, right? The systems. So system related things like it has some GPIOs, timers, phased lock loop, and pulse width modulation module, CAP and QAP. So like this, we have few more additional specifications in OMAP processor, such that it is full flexible. You can design directly, you can take this system on chip, and directly you can connect the peripherals and you can use it for the access of a mobile. So this was the exact OMAP processor which can directly take this specification and we can use it. So whereas like if you can watch in few of the things where you cannot have the video processor additionally. So if you even take the A series processor architecture to design, so Qualcomm will try to take that A series processor architecture, Cortex A series processor architecture, and they again try to have few more additional things. Co-processors and few more specifications which were required for this advancement. So that again, this chip will be taken and by the Samsung few mobiles, like I can say like Redmi and Sony, Apple. So like this, they purchase this Qualcomm. So generally, Apple, what they do, they just take the architecture license and they design their own chips in generally. The Qualcomm tries to take the ARM Cortex architecture license and they design their own chip, and the Qualcomm and Snapdragon series, they try to sell these processors to the particular mobiles, right? Which may be Samsung and few Nokia and other series, other mobile companies. They try to take the chip and they try to add the peripherals in that, and they'll be trying to finally give that particular mobile gadget into the market, right? So this is what happens. So this is what few more advancements in OMAP processor, right? So this makes the completion of the advancement what are running in the real time outside the world, right? So this OMAP processor is helping us. This OMAP processor is helping us to go on with designing. So you guys are going to have such a few architectures in this subject. So in the next session, I'll be planning to have how to program for an ARM processor, right? In the next session, we'll be planning to have how to code or how to program an ARM processor, and that means the total completion of the unit, right? So guys, if you have any doubts regarding this ARM Cortex processor and OMAP processor and its architecture, and if you want to add few more points, you can ask me right now, or you can have a comment on the YouTube so that we can extend towards this session, right? So as per the as we are going with the general JNTUH syllabus, this is much required, this is much enough. for our JNTUH regarding. But yeah, guys, if you want to go with these processor regarding coding, programming, so here we'll be using real-time operating system. So yeah, we can have the additional next sessions like regarding Raspberry Pi, what is its architecture, how we program for Raspberry Pi and other embedded related. So this is what about our session for today. And just have
okay, sir.
Yeah, anything to discuss?